online charter schools are now under investigation.
Indiana Virtual School and Indiana Virtual Pathways Academy are accused of inflating enrollment numbers.
Fox 59's Melissa Crash joins us now in studio with some really interesting new information here.
Very interesting. Yes, I attended the State Board of Education meeting this morning. The state examiner says what they found could be criminal. Here's why.
How did we miss this?
An audit by the Indiana State Board of Accounts found alarming information about two schools, Indiana Virtual School and Indiana Virtual Pathways Academy.
That's the number of students in the school that's reported to the Department of Education over the past 3 years for one school and 2 years for the other was actually inflated by about twice as much.
Based on the report, the state examiner says both schools have substantially misreported.
2016 and 2017, Exhibit 2, 740 students, no assigned courses for semester 1. 1,048 students, no assigned courses for semester 2.
They were students that were added from prior year that had been dropped off or in one instance, a deceased student.
Not only that, but the school received state funding to educate that student along with many others.
While their audit's ongoing, they have concluded already as part of their audit that the ADMs were inflated 50%.
ADM stands for Average Daily Membership. The state uses that number to determine how much money each school gets.
Yes.
The board voted to adjust that number, which now stops funding. That's until the excess tuition funds from the last 3 years are recovered. We're talking $40 million.
So that state tuition support and taxpayer funds are recouped.
The board also voted to enhance student monitoring. Here's what Daleville Superintendent Paul Garrison had to say.
This isn't one of my proudest moments.
Daleville Community Schools, located near Anderson, is the district that oversees the two virtual schools. As the authorizer, they receive 3% of the state funding. The superintendent of the two virtual schools, Percy Clark, provided a statement found in the audit. He calls this a rush to judgment, and the online schools are a last chance for many students.
What the state board has authority over by law is reducing the enrollment to make sure it's accurate if it's like in this case way off.
As for the next step, the investigation continues to determine if this case should be passed on to prosecutors.
And like I mentioned, the investigation is ongoing and there's no timeline as to when it could be completed. Back to you.
Okay, Melissa, thank you. There's a new candidate in